Manually tagging lists in Adobe Acrobat. Lists in Adobe Acrobat, what we want to make sure is assistive technologies, when they encounter a visual list, those usually with the bullet points, numbers, lettered, they need to be able to know that there is a list and also how many items are in the list. In Adobe Acrobat's tags tree, there is a specific way of manually tagging the content. To do this, we are going to create a new tag by doing a right click on the tag above where we want to add the new list. So in this case, as I'm tagging through this document, I'm going to select the heading 3 tag, and I'm going to then do a right click, new tag, and we're going to choose the type of list. All lists need to have the outer list tag in order for assistive technology to know that the following items are part of a list. This includes sublists. So we now have an L tag, a list tag that appears directly below the H3. Now, if we look on the first list in our document, is we right now have a list of two items where we have between the two headings, there is a list of two items, and then each item in that list has a sublist. So to tag this, we are going to then add our first list has two list items. So we'll add new tags, and this is going to be a right click, new tag, and we're going to choose the type of list item. Now there's also an item option for a list item body. This comes through sometimes from Microsoft Word or third-party sources that separate the bullet and the number from the actual text in the document. But to have an accessible list, it is not necessary for it. It isn't something that is announced to assistive technology. So the two tags you need for accessibility are the list tag and the list item. After we select the type for list item, we are going to choose the OK button. Now, if we notice that the list item is directly below the L tag, this is not inside the list tag yet, so they're not associated. So right now, we're just hitting a list and a list item separately. We want to make sure the list item is inside the list. To do that, we can do a right click, cut, and then come up to the L tag and do a right click, paste child. This is going to move the LI or the list item tag inside the list tag. So if we select the caret to the left of the L tag, the list item tag will disappear. Select it again, it'll reappear. The LI tag is a child or inside the list tag. We will add then another list item, and since it's already inside the L tag, we aren't going to have to move it. So we're going to do a right click, new tag. List item is already selected in the type, and so we're just going to choose OK. And now we have our two list items. So that would be the guideline 1.1 text alternatives and the guideline 1.2 base media. So for our first LI, we are going to associate the first part of the text, not the sublist. So in this case, we're going to select in the tags tree the first LI, so it highlights blue. We're going to come to the document. We are going to highlight the first sentence, come back to the tags tree and do a right click, and we're going to create tag from selection. This brings over the text and associates the text. We get our little content box underneath the LI. If I were to select the caret to the left of the LI tag, the content box will disappear. If you select it again, it will reappear. Now, we still have this sublist. Anytime a screen reader is to navigate into a list, we need a new list tag. So inside the LI, we are going to create a new list below the first bit of content. So I'm going to select the content box. I'm going to do a right click, new tag, and from the type, I'm going to choose list. I'm going to select OK. And now a list is inside the LI, but directly below first bit of content. So then I'm going to add then my list item, because there is one item in the sublist. And I'm going to a right click, new tag. The type is going to be a list item. I'm going to select OK. Another way you can move tags around in the tags tree is to drag and drop. So I'm going to click on the LI tag and I'm going to hold and drag my tag so it is inside the LI. So right now there is an arrow and the arrow is slightly to the left of the tag. We want the arrow to be to the right of the tag. And in this case, it will place the tag inside the second L tag. So now we have a list item, the first bit of content, a new list inside the LI, and then that list's LI. And we need to associate the content to that LI tag. So I will select the LI, come into the document. I'm going to select the text for the sublist and come back to the tags tree, do a right click and do create tag from selection. And now when I select this LI, the entire part of the list item is selected and highlighted in purple. If I open it up, we do see that we have the single list item, and that is highlighted when I select the L tag. And we can do the same thing with the next list item. We'll select the list item. I will come to the document and highlight the first bit of text. Do a right click, create tag from selection. I am going to put my cursor and select the content box that has just appeared under the LI. And I am going to create my next list, which has 9 items in it. So I'm going to do a right click, new tag, change the type to a list, and select OK. And then I'm going to add 9 LIs into this list. And in this case, I'm going to use the keyboard command to select the tag. So I'm going to right click, and I'm going to choose the letter key N. And then we're going to change the type to list item. Going to choose OK. And then I'm going to do this 8 more times. So I'm going to do a right click and enter, right click and enter. So that is 9 LIs that still need to be moved inside the L tag. So what I'm going to do is do a multi-select. I'm going to select the first LI. And then I'm going to hold the shift key down. And I will then select the last LI. And I will drag that underneath my list. And then I will associate the tags with their content in the document. And this is how you tag lists and sublists in Adobe Acrobat. Now, something to think about: if your document has a table of contents, the table of contents, the TOC and the TOCI, are the same method.